what are the signs and symptoms we see in pregnancy and how to calculate expected date of delivery. Now we are learning about changes in mother during pregnancy, the physiological changes. Normal average duration of pregnancy in human is 280 days. That will be 40 weeks. It can be calculated from last day of last menstrual period. As pregnancy progresses, various types of extra demands are imposed on the mother's body by growing fetus, which will meet with certain adaptations. Almost all in all organs of the system. We can see physiological changes in the uterus as well as hematological changes, cardiovascular changes, and the changes in the respiratory system, and also changes in the GIT, metabolic changes, and also renal system, endocrine system, changes in the skin, as well as psychological changes we see. We will be dealing with one by one. Changes the body of the uterus to accommodate the growing fetus. There will be marked increase in the uterus, and enlargement is mainly due to hypertrophy and some extent hyperplasia of myometrial smooth muscle fibers. The amount of connective tissue as well as elastic tissue in between the muscle fibers increases. Height and weight, hyperplasia of the uterus increases from 7.5 centimeters to 35 centimeters. Weight also increases 50 to 1000 grams at term. Uterine ligaments show hypertrophy, that means enlargement of the size. Dextrorotation, the uterus is lifted and twisted to the right in 80% of cases. Lower uterine segment is formed from the isthmus. Genital changes, cervix. The edema and congestion because of edema and congestion, it becomes soft. Mucus plug cervical mucus, closing the cervical canal. Increased secretion from its glands. Vulva shows increased vascularity and varicosity. The tough cervix becomes very soft. Endocervix gets hypertrophied. There is increased cervical glands. Due to secretion, there is closure of the cervical canal or operculum. Shows increased vascularity. Soft, moist and bluish distension of vagina at birth. Ovary shows increased vascularity size. One ovary contains the corpus luteum. Pelvic ligaments, relaxation of the ligaments, relaxation of pelvic joints, pelvis becomes more mobile and increases in capacity. Skin changes. Pigmentation due to increased melanocyte stimulating hormone, linea nigra, pigmentation of the linea alba, more marked below the umbilicus. Butterfly pigmentation of the face. Stria gravidarum, stretch of the abdominal wall. Rupture of the subcutaneous elastic fibers. Pink lines in flanks becomes white after the fetal weight usually 3 kgs. Placenta and amniotic fluid 1.5 kgs. Uterine breast enlargement 1 kg. Increase in blood volume and interstitial fluid 1.5 kgs. Fat deposition almost increases 3.5 to 4 kgs. Totally, the woman will gain 10 to 12 or 12.5 kgs at term. There is increased lumbar lordosis, relaxation of pelvic joints and ligaments due to progesterone and relaxin. Urinary changes. Kidneys increased in size as well as effective renal plasma flow is also increased. Call it hydronephrosis. Hydronephrosis we see. And renal plasma flow is because of increased cardiac output and vasodilatation. You see dilatation of ureters, atony of the ureteric muscle caused by progesterone and relaxin and hydroureter. Vesicoureteric reflex increases because of pressure of uterus on the ureters affects more the right ureter due to dextro rotation of the uterus. Changes in the ureter in pregnancy leads to urinary stasis and also pyelitis. And glomerular filtration rate is also increased by 50%. And renal tubular absorption capacity is also increased by 50% due to sodium and chloride ions are also absorbed capacity increased. Clearance rate of substances like creatinine and urea increases. Plasma creatinine, plasma urea values decreases during pregnancy because of clearance rate is increased. Glycosuria is a common physiological phenomenon during pregnancy. Proteinuria occurs due to increased excretion of proteins. During last months of pregnancy, water is retained, excessive water. Decreased protein concentration, especially albumin, leads to decreased colloid osmotic pressure, retention of sodium. Acid-based hyperventilation during pregnancy results in respiratory alkalosis. And kidneys compensate for it by excreting more bicarbonate ions in the urine. Frequency of micturition causes first trimester pressure of the uterus and the bladder, late in pregnancy, enlargement of head. Urinary output diminished in the normal fluid intake. Diminished on a normal fluid intake. Increased in a tubular reabsorption. 100% extra liters of fluid passes into the renal tubules each day. Extracellular water is increased by 6 to 7 liters during pregnancy. This is due to increased amount of aldosterone, progesterone, estrogen hormones. Aldosterone, progesterone, estrogen hormones will be causing increased extracellular water during pregnancy. GIT changes. There will be increased salivation. We call it as tileism. Taste is often altered very early in pregnancy. Increased appetite and thirst. Frequent small snacks they need. And heartburn, reflex esophagitis, relaxation of the cardiac sphincter due to progesterone and relaxation. Emesis gravidae, morning sickness we see in 50%, decreased gastric acidity that interferes with the iron absorption. They will face constipation, reduced, what is meant by constipation? Reduced gut motility due to progesterone, increased water and salt absorption. And also, in addition to this, liver, hepatic synthesis of albumin, plasma globulin, fibrinogen increases, total hepatic synthesis of globulin increases and stimulated by estrogen. Hormone binding globulin rises, gallbladder increases in size and empties more slowly. Relaxation of gallbladder increases the tendency of stone formation. Cholestasis is almost physiological, secretion of bile is unchanged. Falling total peripheral resistance by 6 weeks gestation to a cardiovascular changes. The heart rate changes arises synchronously by 10 to 15 beats per minute. 10 to 15 beats per minute from 70 to 85. Stroke volume is also rises. Cardiac output begins to rise by 40%, 35 to 40% in first pregnancy and 50%. Coming to the cardiovascular blood pressure. Korotkov sounds, 5 used with the auscultatory technique. Slight drop in second trimester, small fall in systolic, greater fall in diastolic blood pressure, opening of arteriovenous shunts at the placenta. Increased pulse pressure will be increased. Supine hypotension syndrome in 80% of women second half of the pregnancy. Maternal hypotension occurs in supine position due to pressure of the uterus on the inferior vena cava. Decreased venous return as well as cardiac output. Plasma noradrenaline is not increased and pulmonary circulation able to observe high rate of flow without any increase in the pressure. Pressure in the right ventricle pulmonary artery capillaries does not change. Pulmonary resistance falls in early pregnancy and progressive venodilatation plus rise in venous distensibility capacitance throughout a normal pregnancy. In addition to this, position of the heart, gravid uterus pushes the diaphragm upwards, resulting change in the position of heart. Heart is displaced laterally upwards and slightly rotated to its long axis. Apex beat of the heart shifts laterally because of above change in heart's position. ECG changes show left axis deviation. To the respiratory changes. Tidal volume rises by 30% in early pregnancy, 40 to 50% by term. Fall in expiratory reserve and residual value, decrease the threshold, increase the sensitivity of medulla oblongata to carbon dioxide driven by progesterone. Respiratory rate does not change. The minute ventilation raises by a similar amount from 7.25 liters to 10.5 liters. Elevation of diaphragm in late pregnancy, dyspnea. Anatomical changes, again, the respiratory system due to elevation of diaphragm by enlarged uterus, it causes increased transverse diameter of thoracic cage and subcostal angle. These two changes in turn increases the air flow across the bronchial tree. So, hyperventilation, high levels of plasma progesterone during pregnancy increases the sensitivity of respiratory neurons to carbon dioxide, resulting in hyperventilation. As a result of the maternal blood, partial perfusion of carbon dioxide decreases by 10 to 15% and partial perfusion of carbon dioxide becomes about 30 millimeters of mercury. Normally, it will be 40 millimeters. And ventilatory functions. Tidal volume increases, vital capacity, there won't be any change. Inspiratory capacity increases, residual volume decreases, functional residual capacity decreases, forced respiratory volume and peak flow rate does not change. Gases exchange. There will be, as I told you, carbon dioxide production rises sharply during third trimester in fetal metabolism increases. A fall in the maternal partial production of carbon dioxide allows more efficient placental transfer of carbon dioxide from the fetus, results in a fall in the plasma bicarbonate concentration. Fall in osmolality, venous pH rises slightly. Increased alveolar ventilation and also rightward shift of the maternal oxyhemoglobin dissociation curve. 2,3-diphosphoglycerate increase. Oxygen unloading to the fetus, that is low partial pressure of carbon dioxide, marked leftward shift of the oxyhemoglobin dissociation curve will lead to all these changes. Respiratory changes. Increased 16% of oxygen consumption by term. Fall in arteriovenous oxygen difference. Pregnancy places greater demand on the cardiovascular than the respiratory system. Changes. Circulating red cell mass increases by 20 to 30%, rise more in multiple pregnancies and iron supplement. Serum iron concentrations falls. Absorption from the gut and iron binding capacity rises. Plasma folate concentration halves by term. Red cell folate concentration falls less. Mild maternal anemia associated with increased placental birth weight ratio or decreased birth weight. Here blood volume, about the blood volume increases during pregnancy to increase the blood supply to the uterus and also to meet the demands and total blood volume increased by 30%. It begins at 12th week, continues till delivery. The plasma volume increases relatively more than that of the red cell volume. That causes hemodilution. That is the cause for physiological anemia in pregnancy. Hematological changes. Erythropoietin rises, especially if the iron supplement is not taken. Erythropoietin to stimulate the erythropoiesis if iron supplement is not taken. Human placental lactogen may stimulate the hematopoiesis. Fall in packed cell volume by 36% in early pregnancy, 32% in third trimester, and also WBC count rises, neutrophil number rises with estrogen. Peak at 33 weeks, stabilizing after that until labor and the puerperium when they rise sharply. The hematological indices, total or RBC count decreases, hemoglobin concentration decreases. Hemoglobin depends upon RBC count. and packed cell volume also decreases, and ESR also there will be increased. Reticulocyte count increases because of reticulocyte count does not change, but their function is suppressed. Women become more susceptible to viral infections, malaria and leprosy. Platelet count and platelet volume are largely unchanged. Gravid uterus exerts pressure on pelvic veins, abdominal veins and femoral veins, thus increasing the venous pressure. The rise in the femoral venous pressure results in edema in the feet, and increased abdominal venous pressure predisposes to varicose veins we see here because of pressure changes, and also piles and peripheral venous thrombosis we can see. These are all because of increased coming to the endocrine changes. The pituitary. Anterior pituitary increased in size, and posterior pituitary releases oxytocin on onset of labor. Thyroid increased in size and activity. Physiological goiter. Most pregnant women are euthyroid. Thyroid binding globulin concentration double. And total T3 T4 are increased, not the free T3 T4. Parathyroid increased in size, activity to regulate calcium metabolism. And adrenals increased in size, activity, total cortisol is increased. And placental hormones, progesterone produced by corpus luteum, levels increased steadily during pregnancy, output reaches 250 milligrams per day. Colon activity reduced, nausea, constipation, reduced bladder and uretric tone, diastolic blood pressure is also reduced, venous dilatation, they raises the temperature. Estrogen source is ovary in early pregnancy. Later, estrogen and estradiol produced by placenta increased a 100-fold. Estriol produced by placenta and fetal adrenals increases the 1,000-fold. Output of estrogen reaches a maximum of at least 30 to 40 milligrams per day. Estriol accounts 85%. Levels increases up to term. And placental hormones, estrogens, possible actions are induce growth of uterus and control its function, responsible for the development of breast, alters chemical constitution of connective tissue, become more pliable, causes water retention, reduces sodium excretion. We can see the lumbar lordosis. Because of pregnancy, the position will be changed. This carbohydrate metabolism. Blood glucose levels increases due to rapid absorption from the gut. Glycosuria is a common lysine due to increased GFR and decreased in renal threshold for glucose. Hepatic glycogen levels decreases. Ketosis may occur due to anorexia, excessive vomiting. Hyperplasia of B cells of the Langerhans of the pancreas due to increased levels of insulin. And basal metabolic rate increased 15% in later half. carbohydrate deposit in the liver as glycogen, as some escape in the general circulation, portion are metabolized by the tissues, converted to fat, depot fat stored as muscle glycogen. First noticeable change occurs in the blood sugar, tested by giving a load of oral glucose tolerance test. The blood glucose after meal remains high, precipitating placental transfer. And with increased placental production of steroid, less glycogen deposition in the liver and the muscles. The effect of fasting is pronounced in pregnancy, overnight fast of 12 hours. Hypoglycemia, production of ketone bodies. Basal metabolic rate, I told you already, increased by 15% during and protein metabolism. Positive nitrogen balance. On average, 500 grams of protein retained by the end of the pregnancy, blood and urea are reduced. Fat metabolism. By 30 weeks, 4 kgs are stored in the form of depot fat in the abdominal wall, back and thighs. Modest amount in the different problems will be felt by the pregnant woman. Extension of occiput in the first vertebra. Suboccipital neuralgia, myalgia, neck pain, stiffness, headache, and sinus problems and allergies we see. And also other problems can also we can see. Not only that, psychological changes. Nervous system shows mild changes in the form of craving for particular type of food items. Alteration in the behavior, emotion, and the mood. A few cases, true psychosis may also develop, but causes not known, and hyperpigmentation. Thank you all.